There's one thing that all babies have in common. They're born with weaker immune systems than adults. We know there are some terrible diseases out here in the cold, cold world, and we also know that if you train the immune system to recognize those threats, they will fight them off. The problem is vaccinations make parents uncomfortable. There's this thing and you're stabbing it into my tiny princess or bouncing baby boy or princess boy or whatever. In order to train the immune system in the best way possible, parents have to follow a strict schedule of injections, often returning to the doctor all the time. Look at this schedule. Different things every month and ranges and specific vaccines at specific times. This is so much scheduling. And different countries have different schedules because they're exposed to different diseases at different times. Ugh. What if you have another kid in like 2 years? Then you have to balance two of these schedules plus your regular parenting and non-parenting lives. What if I told you that researchers had figured out how to do all of this stuff in one, literally one shot? Uno. This is Kevin McHugh.
I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
He's worked with a team to engineer a solution, microfabricated tiny coffee cups or cubes that slowly degrade once inside the body.
You can just go one time and deliver all your vaccines potentially in that one visit. Then you can have someone fully protected against an array of different infectious diseases.
This vaccine has the same contents as a regular vaccine, but it contains a special polymer called polylactic coglycolic acid.
Or PLGA. It's in a lot of different FDA-approved devices, so we think it can be translated to the clinic more readily than perhaps a new material.
The little coffee cups are made using a process similar to the one for computer chips, but instead of silicon, they use PLGA.
The coffee cup analogy works because we actually have a bottom, we have a top, and we fill the liquid in the middle.
The particles are small enough to flow through a needle, so a doctor just needs to inject it into the muscle. Over the next few months, water in the body slowly reacts with the copolymer in a process called hydrolysis. It breaks down into tiny bits of glycolic acid, cleared by the kidneys, and lactic acid, which breaks down into CO2 and water. It's natural. When you feel the burn, that's lactic acid. So again, instead of dozens of visits and injections and worry, one injection and done. Science, take the wheel. Kevin's paper shows that the PLGA breaks down in a predictable way, so they can plan the vaccinations and boosters depending on what needs to happen. The particles are too big for the immune system to worry about, but too small to bother the patient. Even still, we can't talk vaccinations without worries. A 2015 report found 93% of physicians were told by some parents, "No way, this is too many shots at once for my baby. Let's go by our own schedule instead." Even though almost 90% of doctors felt by deviating from this schedule they would put the kid or community at risk, doctors deviated anyway because parents were worried or upset. The CDC mentioned some parents felt all these vaccinations might overwhelm their kid's immune system, which science says it will not. Having one vaccination that does the whole job could relieve a lot of worried parents. We don't have to poke your baby a lot, just once. This future tech isn't just convenient for overbooked middle-class parents either. A single vaccination is life-changing in the developing world, for example.
There's millions of infants every single year that either don't get any vaccines or get one vaccine but don't get the full complement of injections along the schedule. And so all these infants out there are at risk for, you know, contracting these different infectious diseases. And it's not necessarily a cost issue, it's a delivery issue. How do you get the vaccines to the people?
Having a single time-release vaccine for children could quite literally change the world, helping millions of people with and without healthcare security develop immune strength and live longer, healthier lives. We hope you like this video. Before you go, can y'all take a quick sec and subscribe? It really helps us make the show a lot better. Thanks. And if you think this vaccine was weird, the very first vaccine, way weirder, had to do with cows and kids and weird science, check it out over here. If you found any other cool technology we should cover, tweet me at Trace Dominguez or tell us down in the comments. And thanks for watching Seeker.